Hey everybody, it's 40Ware. Welcome back to Bugs Bunny Lost in Time. Last time we met Marvin the Martian and completed Planet X-File, which is the biggest stage in Dimension X. Now we have objects in the mirror closer than they appear. Which means we get to meet our two favorite gangsters again. Why does everybody else have the same car except for Rocky and Muggsy?
Hey, Muggsy, look, a witness. Get that stupid rabbit.
No problem, boss.
Oh, come on. I'm going to say it anyway. Get that rabbit, Muggsy. Okay, Rocky, okay. This is a driving stage, basically. It's in typical Looney Toons fashion. Nothing makes sense. Like the physics, for example. Muggsy is actually a very, very accomplished stunt driver, and he can drive on two wheels. Like, so? Take a right here at the split. There's a golden carrot on this road. And yes, fire hydrants apparently really, really are attracted to you. Clock right there. There's a clock in every place. And as soon as you make it to the end, this happens. You start driving another vehicle, all while the awesome, stereotypical Looney Tunes 1930s gangster inner city suburban Chicago music plays, which is really, really kick-ass and really catchy, actually. This is really catchy music, I'm just saying it right now. Like right now, you can't see it obviously, but I'm actually bobbing and weaving to the music right now. God damn it, I missed. Okay, gotta crash. Hey Muggsy! Sometimes I don't like the jumps because the jumps are kind of finicky, but also kind of glitchy at times. But nothing that would make the game unplayable. And then again, I mean, pretty low budget game, all things considered, so it's natural to believe there would be some. Got it this time, barely. Up and over the top. There we go. This is a very quick stage. This is cool. It's a break. Oh, I love this. You can ring the bell and all three are somehow on a bike. And then this happens. Yeah, Bugs on a unicycle. Come on. This is what I call a driving stage. This is a fun driving stage. This isn't like one of those with very, very simple mechanics. Nothing crazy about it. Wow, Rocky, you got a little happy with the bombs here, I see. Yeah, poor unicycle in the middle of traffic. Yeah, that sounds like fun. And last but not least, this. This is sort of bugged, I think. You hit a gate, you get hurt. Rocky shoots at you, that hurts you. You jump, you get hurt. You jump, you get hurt. For whatever, I don't know why, for whatever reason. Oh yeah, running over a pig hurts. So just take it in stride, I guess. I don't care. Because we're at the end. But it's very simple, and it's got a Looney Tunes spin to it. Nothing crazy about it, really. It's just a fun driving stage that takes a break from the crazy action, such as What's Cookin' Doc and Planet X-File.
Just perfect. You have completed this level.
And it opened up Vortex Room. Okay.
Bye.
But we got 153 carrots. La corrida! Spanish bullfight, in other words. Straight out of, like, Bully for Bugs, I think it's called. Toto! 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 All you have to do is just stand there. Don't really worry about it. All you have to do is just this. Also, a shit ton of carrots there if you need them. But 99 carrots, don't need. You can also send out your cape like that, but it does absolutely nothing. Just stand still and he'll go after you. Three more times and he's toast. I might as well get the barrel out of the way because that will interrupt the charge. Sadly, it does make sense though, sort of. So, most people here in North America probably think of bullfighting as this, but from what I was told from taking Spanish classes, we had to do a little bit of Spanish culture. It's actually far grimmer, a bullfight. Because Matador, if you don't know, Spanish for killer. Yeah. Yeah. And what they actually do is they somehow pirouette around bulls like so. So that part is actually true. And they take pikes and shoot them right into the... Well, Gay Rocky probably knows this because he did something like this in Psychonauts. But yeah, they actually pike the bull at certain points. They spear him and then dance around him for whatever reason. And then, you know, just watch him bleed out to death, I guess, as they keep spearing him. And that's considered a bullfight.
Great.
This is the one time, yeah, there's actually times where I'll agree with Pete on stuff.
Yeah.
Only I'm agreeing, because they would stress cruelty to animals, and while that's true, I think that's actually really, really stupid. How is that fun? You're watching someone pirouette around a bull while throwing spears at him. That doesn't seem too entertaining to me, in my opinion. Well, that's my beef with it, so, I mean, obviously I'm on a little different wavelength compared with PETA, so that means there is hope for me yet. Jeez, I just said I agree with PETA. I guess I'm gonna have to absolve myself afterwards for saying such blasphemy. Wow. I'm probably gonna lose 250 subscribers with that one. Anyway, on to something a little less serious. Vortex room. With this rocket suspended in midair, because that makes total sense in the Looney Tunes world.
Wow! What a big carry! Hey!
Stop, Earthling! This is my special experimental Z-15 Astro Mutant Carrot.
Why is he making mutant carrots? What is his logic behind this? Anyway, Marvin has two attacks. He throws these at you, and you want to throw these back, because obviously if something is staying on the battlefield, it has to be of use. He'll always throw them away from you, so... Yeah, just be aware of that. And he'll occasionally use his fingers in some sort of laser attack. Like that. The thing that makes it tough to avoid is basically because you would never expect it. Okay, one more. And this is a matter of speed. If you're not quick enough, one of the Martians will fall off and Marvin will regain that health. So, you gotta be very quick when you do this. And that's all there is to it. So it seems like kind of a throwaway considering you get four things out of this. But we're done here. So let's see what's next on chopping block. It'd probably be, if I were to venture a guess, it would have to be. Which Way to Albuquerque or something like that from the medieval world.
Great.
Yep. Nice. So we got to unlock another power of ours.
Bye.
Yeah, goodbye, Mile.
So we're at 9 minutes 35 seconds. Do I want to continue with this? Well, why not? This is a really, really quick stage, too, because this is, like, another one of those theme stages. sort of like with the Chicago chase from Objects in the Mirror Closer Than They Appear. This is sort of like that. I don't know whether Bugs pissed off Witch Hazel so much or something like that, but...
Hey, what's up, Witch Doctress? Hey!
I mean, she doesn't even speak a word. She just goes right to the broom to try to bash Bugs into... whatever, like some sort of angry nanny would do if a burglar was going into the house.
Get 10 of these objects to receive a clock symbol.
Okay. Pass this line, run, beat the clock to escape from Witch Hazel. You see the floating 3-second clocks there. And break all the acne boxes. So you have a myriad of things to avoid, such as Witch Hazel's spells here, the obstructions she causes, falling rocks, that's a popular one, crazy platforms. Yeah, it's an interesting one. And then you're focused on getting golden carrots too, yeah. Priority one is speed, obviously, so. That's all that needs to be said about that. Yeah, it's tough to avoid those things. Believe me on that point. It's also kind of funny what happens if Witch Hazel actually catches you and you don't beat the time. I'll probably show it off in the last area. Last area is the toughest, in my opinion, no question about it. Because these I can probably beat with about 15 to 30 seconds left on the clock. That one is more like 5 to 10. Just because it's not easy. And you'll see why. Also, the trees and falling debris never actually hit you. So logically, I mean, that makes total sense. Too bad Witch Hazel doesn't seem to understand that point. Windmill Road. Wow, nice ride for face dudes once more and once again. Yep. And you get to hear the only time in the game where there's alternate sound effects for collecting carrots and stuff. Whip. Sounds like the game had a hiccup. Sounds like someone went into that file that had the soundbite and just started hiccuping all over. Sir Day collect the carrots like hiccup. I'm gonna stop. That sounds really, really retarded. It does not. Okay, we made it to the end of this. So now in the fourth one, which is the farm one. What you're supposed to do is jump on a pig and hit the jump button quickly after. Do that with all this stuff. And you can collect carrots, I mean clocks this way. All while avoiding the falling anvils and the windmill, which actually can be a huge time waster. If you don't time things right. Well, anyway, like I said, I'm gonna show this off once. Because I can. That was kind of glitchy. Here's what Witch Hazel does if you get caught. This is kind of cute. The cauldron falls on you. So from out of nowhere, it's like Witch Hazel hired a FedEx or something by air and just ships it directly to Bugs. Hey, so the person just goes there and is like, hey, is that Bugs Bunny? Yeah, we got a delivery from you from Witch Hazel. What is it? Falling cauldron. Oh, Looney Tunes logic. Ain't nothing like it. And, well, I'm exalting myself from my hatred for PETA and the one time I agreed with PETA by jumping on the backs of a lot of pigs. No comment. Finally. The 10th Acme box. And Merlin's standing right here for whatever reason.
Hello, Travel Hare. I can teach you a magical trick if you like.
Great!
All right, listen carefully, Rabbit. I'll teach you a magical tune that activates several devices.
The magical tune is useful for two areas as of right now, so I'm going to take care of them in the next part. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.